Very warm welcome from Islamabad, Pakistan. My name is Khalid Latif, and I am the Program Director Middle East at the Center of Pakistan and International Relations, COPAIR. COPAIR is a non-profit, non-partisan strategic think tank that advances solutions to Pakistan's national policy objectives through high-quality research and analysis. It is a pleasure to welcome you all today to this online conversation on Pakistan through the lens of Middle Eastern geopolitics. The geopolitical and geoeconomic forces that bind these two regions together is an area of growing focus and interest for us here at COPAIR, and for very good reason. Pakistan's Middle East policy, with its own strengths and weaknesses, is born out of the region's power dynamics underpinned by sectarian and economic configurations. Although the Middle East often presents itself as a geopolitical battleground where external powers tend to settle their contentions, Pakistan's relations with its long-standing allies in the Middle East have become uneasy since its decision to remain neutral in the Yemen war. The Middle East for decades has been one of the primary sources of financial support for Pakistan. Pakistan maintains close military ties with Saudi Arabia, providing extensive support, arms, and training for the Saudi armed forces. Since the 1970s, Pakistani soldiers have been stationed in Saudi Arabia to protect the kingdom. However, in the last few years, geostrategic compulsions have necessitated Pakistan to adopt a balancing act in order to safeguard its core national interests. Centrifugal forces unleashed in the Middle East has pushed the main regional powers into at least two opposing blocs. On the one hand, we have countries that could be described as supporter of transnational political Islam, including Turkey under President Erdogan and Malaysia under the former Prime Minister Mohamed Mahathir, versus on the other side, countries advocating for a more nationalistic outlook on international politics, such as the UAE and Saudi Arabia under Crown Prince Mohammed bin Zayed and Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. Such dynamics have in effect reshaped the cartography of relations between the Middle East and Pakistan. Joining me to unpack these developments and much, much more are five excellent and distinguished list of speakers who I shall introduce in order of appearance. Our first speaker from Pakistan is Lieutenant Naeem Lodhi, a former Defense Secretary of Pakistan. The title of his talk shall be U.S. Exit from Afghanistan and Implications for Pakistan. From the U.S., we have Dr. Marvin Weinbaum, Director of Afghanistan and Pakistan Studies at the Middle East Institute. The title of his talk shall be Pakistan Navigating the Shoals of Middle East Politics. Also from the U.S., we have Arif Rafiq, President of Wiser Consulting. The title of his talk will be Pakistan-Saudi Relations in the Era of Mohammed bin Salman. From the UK, we have Umar Karim, Visiting Fellow, Royal United States United Services Institute. The title of his speech will be Power Politics of the Middle East and Pakistan. Last but not least, from Pakistan, we also have Brigadier Samson Simon Sarraf. The title of his speech is going to be The Greater Middle East. Our moderator for today's session is Raja Faisal, who is a senior journalist and executive editor of the Asian Telegraph. Over to you, Raja Faisal.
In the region as well as in the world. Now, we will go towards our chairperson for the concluding remarks. Amna Malik is the president of COPAIR and editor-in-chief of the Asian Telegraph and Melange International Magazine. Under her dynamic leadership, COPAIR is working on national and international security, social, political, and economic aspects of emerging technologies, and many more other initiatives. She has been awarded from the President of Pakistan, Dr. Arif Alvi, and former Prime Minister of Malaysia, Mahathir Mohamad, for her extraordinary efforts and contributions for Pakistan. And very recently, Amna Malik and I, we were awarded with the Pride of Pakistan from ISPR, Pakistan Army. So this is another badge to her. Ma'am, floor belongs to you now, please.
Thank you very much, Faisal. Thank you very much, my all worthy speakers and moderator and my Copia team. Assalamu alaikum. I'm really thankful to all of you. You gave your precious time and we noted down your all recommendations and suggestions that how Pakistan emerged as a great power among the Muslim countries and can play its key role. And we also believe that there is a need of a change and revision of foreign policy of Pakistan towards Middle East. We started with General Khalid Lodi Saab. I'm a great admirer of him. He always spoke very well, and he highlighted that the US exit from Afghanistan and what would be the future role of Pakistan in this regard. So the main key point which he highlighted is that it is very important for Pakistan to have a peaceful and stable Afghanistan. And that is only possible when Pakistan and Iran plays a key role, and they should not be involved in any kind of proxy war on one side. And on the other hand, we should not allow any foreign power to use our bases for their own motives. So we need to change our policy, and there we can play a very important role. Other than that, he also highlighted that US seeks to maintain its influence in Afghanistan in one way or another. So we need to keep in mind that how it affects our CPAC project and other projects and our relations with Middle East and other countries, keeping in mind the US-China containment policy. Later, Mr. Marvin joined us. He highlighted well two foreign policy principles of Pakistan. One was the search for allies to support the Kashmir cause in the international platform. And on the other hand, also seeking the financial assistance. He also highlighted that Pakistan is projecting itself well as a facilitator. So Pakistan can balance its role among the various Muslim regional blocs, and it keeps on working on its reconciliation policy. Later on, Mr. Arif Rafiq, I listened to you for the first time. You highlighted the MBS era and how you highlighted Pakistan's strategic policy with Saudi Arabia in the historical perspective. And you also give us certain ideas that how we can play, Pakistan can play an important role in 2030 MBS vision. And I think you are absolutely right that we need to work on further economic ties. And you also highlighted that how Pakistan played its role during the Yemen crisis and also during Pakistan-Saudi and Pakistan-Iran relations. Later, Mr. Umar Karim discussed about the bloc politics. And this is really interesting at the moment because we need to keep our eyes close to this thing, that these new regional alliances are going to have an impact on not only on the Middle East, but also on the Pakistan foreign policy. And then later he highlighted the Pakistan, Malaysian, Turkey, Troika versus GCC. That is also very important. He also showed his worry about the labor force because, you know, Indian labor force is replacing with the Pakistani labor force in GCC countries. So this is something which is very important, and he highlighted well. And he also mentioned that we need to look for the new era of cooperation rather than only focusing on the traditional security partnerships. Finally, Brigadier Samson Sharif, I really appreciate his work on Middle East. Sir, you highlighted the Greater Middle East, a quest, your writing on it. And I think you rightly said that US regional politics is going to an end. And there is going to be either multipolar world or there will be a multipolar influence in the Middle East. And there, Pakistan can play an important role if we are stable. We need to change our foreign policy and diplomatic maneuvering by asking for financial assistance, but we should work on economic reliance. You highlighted two very important points, and I believe when MBS visited Pakistan, along with him, there was a big delegation of business community who were interested to invest in Pakistan. And also in this BRI perspective, CPEC is something very important. So we need to play our cards well, but that is only possible when we are strong enough to work for our country and we make it economically stable. Finally, there are few recommendations on the behalf of Center of Pakistan and International Relations. After listening to all the worthy guests, we are thankful. First of all, we believe that there is a complete shift. There is a need of a complete shift in the foreign policy of Pakistan, because we always follow the policy of neutrality. So we need to see that whether we need to make we need to go for economic regional alliances like with China, Pakistan, Turkey, Malaysia, or we need to go and work as a peace advocate, because you know this can also be a bargaining tool. But wherever there is a like Pakistan can play a very important role by developing a balancing between Saudi Arabia and Iran on one hand, and on the other hand, Pakistan also can play an important role by replacing India as a bread basket for GCC, because Pakistan is also an agriculture country. We can offer some better prices to the GCC countries. We can request the government should give some subsidies to the exporters for the food products, so that we can also capture that industry. We also need to change our foreign policy, because economic priorities are always important as compared to the other priorities. That is also one of the reasons that our neighbor is gaining its power and it is getting better priority as compared to our Pakistani trader market. So I believe that economy plays a very important role in the foreign policy. So commerce and trade is also going to play a very important role. Regarding Palestine, I believe that we need to stick to our Palestine issue. And I think our government played a very important role, because this issue also always we stand for, we always look for our support for our Muslim brothers for our Kashmir issue. So we need to support the Palestine issue, and wherever there is some human right violation of the Muslim world, Pakistan as an advocate of peace should stand ahead, and there Pakistan can play a very important role. As we all mentioned earlier, that geopolitics scenario is changing. So Pakistan is a gateway from east to west. So this gateway can be utilized if there is a peace in Afghanistan. And I think now economic priorities are more important. So maybe there is a chances of some regional alliances and some kind of understandings and consortiums on the economic side. So I think Pakistan needs to use its card of economic security as one of the tool. And Pakistan is inshallah going to play an important role in Middle East politics and also in overall world, because we are the gateway from east to west. Finally, somebody mentioned that there should be some centers on Middle East. So I just want to highlight that the National Security Division developed a working group in which COPAIR is one of the, is also playing an advisory role. Then the Foreign Office think tank is also developing a group on the Middle East. Then there is, and also in COPAIR, we are also working and we develop a working group on Middle East, which is headed by Khalid Saab. So if there is any recommendation, we would like you to be the part of that working group. We always welcome you. If you are in Pakistan, we would like to host you in Islamabad in our office. And if you are virtually available, we can have the virtual meetings so that your valuable suggestions we keep on getting. And the final document, inshallah, we are going to present to the Foreign Office, to the foreign ministers. And I think this is the time, Brigadier Saab, Janat Saab, Arif Saab, Umar Saab, and Marvin, we need your support. Because Pakistan can play a very important role, and that's why we gather together. And we are looking forward to work with you. And if there is any recommendation or anything which we are unable to highlight today, so kindly feel free to share with us. Thank you very much. I think Brigadier Saab, you wanted to say something. Kindly unmute.
Sir, you need to unmute yourself, sir. Yes.
Amna, thank you very much. I don't like to say anything. So kind of you.
Thank you very much. And to all of the participants and to all of the thinkers today, it was an honor for me to moderate amongst you and host this event. It was an honor for COPAIR. And on behalf of COPAIR and my chairperson and my colleagues, I would end here, and it was a lovely evening for me, and I hope it was the same for you as well, being with us. Thank you very much. That's it. End.